Good afternoon, everyone. So today we are going to discuss the topic pulse, pulse rate and heartbeat. So first of all, let us start with the topic pulse. Okay, if you will place your middle finger and your index finger on the left wrist like this, you can just feel there is a throbbing movement, upward and downward movement. You might have felt this. Okay, just keep your fingers here and you can just feel there is a throbbing movement. That throbbing movement, this is known as pulse. Clear? You can just feel this. Clear? And why is there a pulse? It is due to the blood that is flowing in the arteries. You know that the blood is flowing in the arteries. Due to that blood which is flowing in the arteries, we feel this movement. That is known as pulse. So it is caused due to the blood that flows in the arteries. Clear? And if I talk about why the blood is flowing in the artery, due to your heart. Your heart is beating. Your heart is contracting and relaxing simultaneously. Okay, your heart is contracting and then relaxing. And due to that contraction and relaxation, there is a pulse. Is that fine? Your heart is showing contraction and relaxation. This one, contraction and relaxation, it makes a heartbeat. You know that your heart is made up of muscles. Your heart is having muscles. And with the help of those muscles, your heart contracts and relaxes. One contraction and relaxation, it constitutes a heartbeat. And due to one heartbeat, we are having one pulse. Is it fine? Now, if I'll talk about in terms of 1 minute, throbbing movement is known as pulse. If you will count your pulse in 1 minute, means just keep your finger like this here for 1 minute and just keep on counting the throbbing movement. That is your pulse rate. Now, what do you mean by the pulse rate? Pulse in 1 minute. Clear? Is it fine? One heartbeat is responsible for one pulse. So basically the rate of heartbeat will tell the rate of the pulse. Pulse in 1 minute will be determined by the rate of the heartbeat. Our heart beats 70 to 80 times in 1 minute. So if you will place your fingers like this and you will count the movement for 1 minute, it will come out to be 72 to 80. Because if one time your heart is beating, you can feel one pulse here. Second time, second pulse. Like in the similar way, if your heart is beating for 1 minute, you are counting the pulse for 1 minute, that is the same. Clear? So heart is beating due to the presence of the muscles. Your heart is having muscles. Due to those muscles, the heart is showing the contraction and relaxation. And that contraction and relaxation of the heart constitutes a heartbeat. Due to the heartbeat, the blood flows in the arteries. And that blood flows in the arteries, you can feel. There is a throbbing movement, that is pulse. Is it fine? Now, we can measure the heartbeat. We can just listen the sound which is produced by the heart with the help of an instrument which is known as the stethoscope. Stethoscope is an instrument that you might have seen with the doctors. They use this instrument to amplify the sound which is produced by the heart. Okay, your heart produces two sounds. Okay, that are being listened by the doctors with the help of this stethoscope. Now, you can make a homemade stethoscope also. Just take a funnel like this. Now, here is the stem of the funnel. This is the stem. Okay, on the stem of the funnel, you can just use any kind of the rubber tube. Attach a rubber tube here like this. I hope I am clear with this. Okay, and on the mouth of the funnel, here is the mouth of the funnel. We can just attach a balloon sheet or a rubber sheet like that. We have to stretch the sheet tightly. Okay, now here is your homemade stethoscope. Just keep this funnel on your chest here and this tube on your ear, and then you can just listen the sounds of the heart, and for 1 minute you cannot. You will listen the sound for 72 to 80 times. That what I told you, the rate of the heartbeat is 72 to 80 times in a minute. Is it fine? Okay, now let us talk about the structure of the stethoscope. Okay, firstly, in the structure of a stethoscope, there is a chest piece that is kept on the chest. So there is a chest piece. Clear? Then there is a tube. Like this. And then there are two tubes. Like two ears are there. So for that, two tubes are there. Clear? Like this. So like this. This chest piece is kept on the chest cavity. As you know, that heart is present in the chest cavity. And then two pieces, two tubes, they are inserted in the ear. And the doctor, they used to listen the heartbeat. Clear? So stethoscope is an instrument which is used to amplify the sound of the heart. William Harvey, he discovered the circulation of blood first of all. So now we have discussed about the circulatory system. In the circulatory system, we have discussed the topic blood vessel, and then heart. So now let us start the another topic, that is excretion and the excretory system in case of human being. First of all, what do you mean by the term excretion? As you know that the cells of our body, they perform so many processes. They perform so many functions. And while functioning, obviously they will produce certain kind of the waste products. Or I can say, while the functioning, the cells of our body produce some kind of the waste products or some kind of the products that are useless for the body. So there is a need to remove these waste materials. Why? If these waste materials will not be removed from the body, they will be toxic. They will harm the body. So there is a need to remove these substances. And the process of removing the waste products is known as excretion. Am I clear? What is excretion? The process of removing waste materials from the body is known as excretion. Clear? So now, our body, if I talk about the excretion, then our body shows different kinds of the excretion, like exhalation. We have discussed in chapter number 2, nutrition in animals. In exhalation, we are just excreting. We are removing the undigested food. So in exhalation, we were removing the undigested food through the anus, right? Undigested food is removed. Then you might have experienced sweating. That is also a kind of excretion. In sweating, we sweat basically, right? And that sweat, it contains 95% of the water, some amount of the salt. Clear? That is a kind of excretion also. Then exhalation. In the previous chapter only, in chapter number 10, we have studied that we used to exhale the CO2. Again, CO2 is a waste product for our body. Our body doesn't need it. So we are removing the CO2. That is exhalation. It is again removing the waste product. So in this, we are removing the undigested food. We are just removing the unwanted salts, water. We are just removing the CO2. these all are different kinds of the excretion. Is it fine? These all are different kinds of the methods by which we remove the waste products. Now, apart from these waste product, there is one more waste product that is being produced by our body. Nitrogenous waste, urea. Our body produces urea as well. This is a nitrogenous waste product. A waste product that is having nitrogen in its chemical structure. Now, how this urea is removed from the body, let us talk about. Clear? Now, for this process, we are having a system that is known as excretory system. This urea, or I can just simply use the term waste product. This harmful waste product is in the blood. Now there is a need to remove the urea. There is a need to remove the harmful nitrogenous waste. Clear? So for that we are having the excretory system. You know that our excretory system is having a pair of kidney. These are bean shaped. You have seen rajma bean. This is somewhat like that. Then ureters are there like that. Clear? Here we are having kidney, ureter. Then there is a muscular bag-like structure which is known as the urinary bladder. Like this. So here is the urinary bladder. Then there is a small tube, urethra, which opens out through an opening, urinary opening. Okay, there is a small tube that is urethra, and this urethra opens outside the body, that is urinary opening. Now understand the process of excretion, how the process of excretion is taking place in the human body. The blood will come. Okay, now what will happen in the kidney? The waste materials will be filtered out. Okay, the blood will come in the kidney. In the kidney, the waste materials will be filtered out. And the useful substances will be absorbed back by the blood. Am I clear? The harmful substances will be filtered out and will come in the kidney. The useful substances will be absorbed back by the blood. Now here we are having the harmful substances. The useful substances are absorbed back. Okay. Now, the harmful substances, now they are known as the urine. Now this urine will move like this. Through the ureter in the urinary bladder. In the urinary bladder, it will get accumulated. It will get collected. The urinary bladder is a muscular bag-like structure. It can expand. So the urine will keep on collecting. And after that, with the help of the urinary opening, like this, the urine will be discharged out. Okay, so this is the process of excretion. A healthy human, on an average, in a day, excretes 1 to 1.8 liter of urine. Am I clear? No. Like I told you, in human, the nitrogenous waste product is urea. But that is not the same in all the organisms. Animals are of three types on the basis of their nitrogenous product. Okay, animals are of three types on the basis of their nitrogenous excretory product. Nitrogenous excretory product. First type of organism, they excretes ammonia. Second type of organism, they excretes urea. In this category we belong. And third type of the organism, they excretes uric acid. बेसिकली इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द वॉटर. इफ द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द वॉटर इज मोर देन अमोनिया विल बी एक्सक्रीटेड. एंड इफ द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द वॉटर विल बी मॉडरेट देन यूरिया विल बी एक्सक्रीटेड. एंड इफ द अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ वॉटर विल बी क्वाइट लेस देन द यूरिक एसिड विल बी एक्सक्रीटेड. नाउ लेट मी एक्सप्लेन दिस विद द एग्जाम्पल. फिशेज, you know that fishes live in the water, they have adequate supply of the water, so in them the excretory product is ammonia. Human being, we are having moderate amount of the water, so we excrete urea. And if I'll talk about the uric acid, birds, they used to fly in the sky, they are having shortage of water, okay, so they used to excrete the uric acid, a semi solid waste. So birds excrete uric acid. Am I clear? No. We used to sweat. Have you ever thought what is the function of that sweat? Sweat keeps our body cool. So sweating is good. Sweat keeps our body cool. Why? You can compare this with an example. If you just keep a water in an earthen pot, what will happen? The water will become cool. Have you thought why? Yes, it is due to the process of evaporation from the holes. The water will evaporate and as a result, the water will cool down. The similar thing is happening here also. Okay, evaporation causes cooling. In the sweat, obviously, water is there. So, sweating causes cooling. Sweating causes cooling. Am I clear? Thank you.